Hope you are seeing these values clearly. And here I put the random values here, and whatever the unit you have, you can put also, like in microgram or milligram or whatever you have the values, you can put it here. So firstly, we have to create here the scatter plot for the calibration curve. So for that, I'm just selecting our values of concentration as well the absorbance. Now insert scatter this first graph here, and by here layout we can put according to our choice. So here we can see we have this absorbance, and here we have the axis, x and y axis, and we know that on the x axis we always put here the independent variable. So we can type here our independent variable, like we have the concentration and on the y-axis we always have our dependent variable, that is our absorbance. So now here I'm just clicking on one of its dot, and here we can see a trend line. Now here we should have to see, it should have to be linear, and we are displaying equation on the chart as well, display our regression value, R square value on the chart. And here are different thing we can use, like I'm just picking here the red color with its different width. Here we can pick our width and whatever the thing by which we want to represent our data. So here is the y value, here is a formula which is here, and here is also the r square value, that is the 0.995. and here I would like to mention that we know that y is equals to mx plus c, the formula is here, where the m, or we can see the a, x or b. So here is the first one, this value is of slope value and this one is of intercept value. So here it is mentioned, and we don't need this legends here, so I'm just deleting it. And here we have this, so I'm just setting it out here on this side. Okay, like this we have our calibration chart here. So this thing you know very well. And now here the thing, unknown absorbance, we should have to know, which we had this value come from the experiment. Whatever the value you have, you can put it here, like for example I'm just to put here the 0.48 absorbance of the unknown sample, unknown test sample. And here we have to put the formula, which is equal to trend. We have to open the parenthesis, then we have to select the concentration, now we have to put here the comma, that is the important part. And now I am just picking it up and dragging it down of the absorbance. Now again I am putting here the comma, which is the essential part, otherwise you will not get your answer. And now we have to select this unknown absorbance value. Now we have to close our parenthesis. I'm just entering it, and here is the value of the unknown concentration. So hope this will help.